Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I have a really spicy and flavorful recipe for you guys. Today's video, I'm going to be sharing a pepper chicken recipe. Now this right here is not a traditional Guyanese recipe, not a traditional Caribbean recipe or anything like that. This is just something I came up with and not traditional at all, but it's very, very delicious. Basically, it is seasoned fried chicken chunks, and then they're going to be tossed up with lots of hot pepper, of course, because it's called pepper chicken, and lots of different crunchy vegetables. It can be served as cutters, like when you're drinking, or it can also be served over some white rice alongside some chow mein, lo mein, whatever the case may be. This is very, very delicious. So if you want to see how I put this recipe together, please keep on watching. All right, everyone, we're going to start by seasoning our chicken. So into some chicken breast that I've cut up into small chunks and washed very well, I'm going to be going in with a little bit of soy sauce, and then I'm going to be adding in some everything but the bagel seasoning from Trader Joe's. This right here has sea salt, it has sesame seeds, it has garlic and onion flakes in it, so go ahead and purchase this from Trader Joe's if you have the chance to. On top of that, I'm going to be going in with some Chinese five spice powder as well as some parsley flakes. You can also use fresh parsley or green seasoning if you wish. I'm also going to be going in with some ground turmeric, so this way I can get a nice yellow color, as well as some ground ginger, lots of garlic powder or granulated garlic, and I'm also going to be going on with a lot of ground hot pepper. So what I did was basically took some wiri-wiri peppers or any hot peppers of your choice, grind them up or chop them up very finely, and go ahead and mix it all with the chicken and the rest of those spices. Again, if you did not want to use all of these different dried spices, you can definitely put fresh on there. I'm just making this easier for people who are trying to make something in a very quick manner versus something that takes a little bit longer. Now at this point, once you mix everything together, you're going to top it off with some cornstarch. Now what the cornstarch is going to do is it's going to give it a very crispy exterior without making it too thick and too heavy when we go to fry it. So I'm going to add my cornstarch in, I'm going to mix everything up well, and then I'm going to show you guys how to fry. As usual, all of the ingredients and the measurements will be listed in the description box down below this video. All you have to click is the drop down menu below the video and you'll see the ingredients and the measurements pop up. At this point, once you season your chicken and coat it with the cornstarch, it is time to start frying. So in my pan, I'm going to fill my pan about 1/3 of the way up with some vegetable oil. You can also use canola oil or any type of light tasting oil. And I'm going to heat it up on a medium high heat. Once your oil has come up to temperature, you're going to start dropping the chicken pieces in one at a time. Make sure you put them in individually because sometimes when you add that cornstarch, they tend to stick together. And you want to make sure that your chicken pieces are nice and separated or else they'll never get crispy. So I'm going to keep them in the oil here and I'm going to keep on turning them until they're finished cooking. This should take about 3 to 5 minutes. Again, make sure to keep an eye on your chicken, keep on turning it and rotating it so this way every side of it gets crispy and it gets an even golden brown coating. Make sure you do not step away because it could burn being that the chicken pieces are so small. And after exactly 4 minutes, my pieces of chicken were done cooking. It might take a little bit longer or a little bit less for you guys just depending on how big you cut it. All I'm going to do now is remove them from the oil and drain them on a plate that I've put some paper towel on. And all I'm going to continue to do now is frying the rest of my chicken pieces. So part one of this recipe is all done. If you really wanted to, you can make a nice little spicy dipping sauce or even use some ketchup or pepper sauce and eat these pieces of chicken just as they are. Or you can go ahead and take it to another level like I'm going to do and make my pepper chicken. So let's get into it. Now once you finish frying all of your chicken chunks, it is time to saute it back with some fresh veggies, seasonings, and some sauces. So what we're going to do in a heavy bottom pan or a wok like I have here, I'm going to add in some canola oil or vegetable oil, and then I'm going to be going in with some thinly sliced garlic cloves. And on top of that garlic, I'm going to be going in with my thinly sliced hot peppers as well as some pimento peppers or seasoning peppers. You can use as much or as little hot peppers as you'd like. Again, this is pepper chicken, so I made it very spicy. I added in a whole Scotch bonnet pepper, but if you wanted to make it a little more mild or not spicy at all, feel free to do that as well. All I'm going to do is stir fry these ingredients for just about 30 seconds. And after about 30 seconds, once everything gets nice and aromatic, it is time to go in with some thinly sliced carrots. And when I'm adding in all of these veggies here, I'm not going to overcook them. I want them to be nice and crispy still, so they're just going to get a very quick stir fry. And after about 2 minutes, I'm going to be going in with my thickly sliced cabbage. Now, the carrots went in first just because they're harder and they take a little bit more time to cook. But the cabbage, as well as the onions that I'm going in with now, they don't really take that long to cook. They're just going to take about 1 to 2 minutes themselves. So I'm just going to stir fry all of these veggies with the aromatics for just about 2 to 3 minutes or until the onions and the cabbage softens up slightly. Remember, you do not want them mushy or overly wilted. You want them to have a nice crunch to them still.
And once the veggies are cooked to your liking, you're gonna go back in with all of that chicken that we had fried up. And at this point, we're also gonna go in with our sauce. Now my sauce is a mixture of sweet chili sauce, regular soy sauce, sweet soy sauce, which is darker and thicker in texture, and I've also went in with just a little bit of honey and a little bit of sriracha. I mixed all of that together and I'm adding that into my chicken now, and I'm gonna toss it up to get it nice and coated. And like I had mentioned previously, to get all of the ingredients and the proper measurements of everything, I'll have it listed in the description box below the video. And as soon as you toss everything up, it is done. What I'm gonna do now is just sprinkle on a little bit of that Everything But The Bagel seasoning from Trader Joe's. Now, if you didn't have that, you can also just use some sesame seeds. You can buy that at any grocery store, really. Just so this way it adds a nice little crunch and that sesame flavor. And that is it, guys. That is how quick and simple it is to put this amazing and flavorful dish together. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this one. Go ahead and serve this with white rice, fried rice, chow mein, or lo mein. You could also serve it with a side of steamed vegetables or even eat it by itself. Whatever floats your boat, it will be delicious.
I hope all of you lovely people out there enjoyed this video today. If you enjoyed, don't forget to give this video a nice big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you are not subscribed yet. And come on over and join the Matthew's Guyanese Cooking family. All you have to do is click that red subscribe button and click the bell notification icon and drop those comments down below.